Always wanted to do that. When Paul asked me, I was like, yeah, sure. Why not? Let's do this. I grew up here at Immanuel all my life, and I'm happy to be here today to tell you about some little conversations that I've had as I've grown up in this community. To get this started, I kind of went into confirmation with a bad attitude. One of my friends who is a year older than me told me that confirmation was kind of boring and it was kind of nerdy. And so after my first day of confirmation, I was like, what? What are you talking about? This is fun. Singing songs and talking about all kinds of cool stuff in our small groups. And the small groups are where I had my first great little conversations. Deb Garvey was my small group leader, and we had some amazing little conversations. One of the greatest tools that she gave me in that small group was this little prayer box. And she told us that we could put all sorts of things that would remind us to pray in this box. So I put drawings, Bible verses, poems, you name it, I put it in there. And every now and then, yes, I still have it, I go back to it and I look what's in there. Maybe put something new. My next little conversation that I had was a conversation with Laura Herzog. As I grew up into eighth grade, she invited me to high school time, and I wasn't in high school yet, and so I thought that was really cool. We would go to Byerly's and just kind of eat food, and I wouldn't talk too much because these are high schoolers, and I was a little bit intimidated, but that was another meaningful conversation. The next conversation that I had was alongside a St. Louis mission trip. Now, when it comes to mission trips, we kind of did these sponsorships, and this was more of a distant conversation that started, but my sponsorship was George Shell. George sponsored me on that mission trip, and so when I went on this mission trip to St. Louis, I wrote him a postcard that said something like, "Hey, George, serving down here, one in the arch, having a great time." Sent it off. Didn't really think too much of it. Still to this day, George will come up to me and say, "You know, a while back I got a postcard from some young kid wreaking havoc in St. Louis." Another great little conversation. Sundays, as I grew up here and Paul Erdman started, I would go to the 11 o'clock service, and afterwards we would have little Bible studies. And I do mean little Bible studies because it would be Paul, myself, and maybe two other students. And that little conversation that we would have on Sunday mornings meant a lot to me now as I look back, because Paul didn't care that it was a smaller group. He cared that we were there and that we were there to talk about the Bible. A great little conversation. Another great conversation doesn't really involve words. This little conversation happened backpacking, as many of you have done. Backpacking, I went with Paul Nelson and my buddy Nick Grillo. We were in a tent together. And one night, near the end of the week, we might have been a little dehydrated because one joke was said and another joke, and we couldn't stop laughing. We literally were rolling around on our sleeping bags laughing so hard. Our sides hurt. And, yep, we'll leave it in the tent. It was funny. It was good. A great conversation. Another great little conversation that came to me my junior or senior year of high school, came when I was talking with Martin Rathjen over at Caribou on a Wednesday night. We went over there and he sat down next to me and said, you know, so Justin, what do you think you're going to be doing in the next years? And at that time, I was in high school, and I was like, I don't know. I don't really care. I'm in high school. Woo! And so Martin looked at me and said, have you ever thought about doing youth ministry? And that was a little seed that got planted in my head, and I was like, youth ministry. I enjoy it here at church. I have made all sorts of great friends. I've been one anothered a number of times. So I thought about it for a while. These caring little conversations have impacted my faith life tremendously. They've pushed and nudged me to where I am today. And today I'm actually working in youth ministry over at Prairie Lutheran Church just across town. I continue these conversations with these people whenever I stop by, maybe say hi to George, have our little conversation, or when I'm in need of some advice in youth ministry world, I'll call Paul or I'll call Martin, I'll say, what do I do? I'm so thankful for these little conversations that I've had all throughout my life. And now I'm very thankful that I get to have those little conversations with lots and lots of young people. Amen.